Hey, it is Technical Tiki Tuesday, and this is the week that we are going to do our darndest to get this thing finished. Now, it's going to be a short week. We're going on a little camping trip, so I don't think I'm going to have time to get this in the mold, but we're definitely going to get it finished, and we're going to get it ready for molding. I'm in the final stages of the sculpture, which is ridiculous nitty-gritty smoothing and polishing and getting everything right, and noodling with forms. Mrs. VanTiki came up with a great idea for adding a little cooler shape to the mouth over here, so that's what I'm doing this morning. So putting that in, and then I've got to go re-smooth that out. I'm working on some undercuts here. Just lots of little finessing. So we're going to be putting this in, we're going to be smoothing it, and we're going to finish it. People often ask me what the secret is for smoothing out clay, and I wish I knew an answer. The only way that I know is just spending a lot of time working from larger tools like this to a smaller tool like this, and you're just constantly erasing the tool marks from the previous larger tool. After this, I'll switch over to some spritzes of alcohol and a stiff brush to further smooth. And then from this, I will go to a stiff sponge. Now, I'm still kind of figuring monster clay out, and I'm trying different things, so this is what's working best for me right now, but, you know, you never know what I'll discover later. Okay, I've gone through with this super, super fine loop tool. Is it going to focus on that? It's made of a guitar string, and I'm ready to do some final smoothing. To do that, I'm going to be using this. It's mineral spirits. Now, this will dissolve the monster clay. It can be very aggressive, though, as for solvents. So I'm going to be using an extremely small amount on the brush, very soft brush. And yeah, you just want to be careful. A little bit goes a very long way. I know lots of folks will use brushes almost like sandpaper, working from a rough brush all the way down to a fine brush. For me, I like to just go with a super, super fine soft brush for a nice surface. There's one little like scuff right here. It's right here. Urgh. See if I can get that one spot. Kidneys. We're getting really close, but I still want to smooth out just a little bit. I'm going to go back in here with the rake tool again and just round out the inside of that mouth. Well, yeah, just a little bit more. And then I think this is going to be done. Okay, this is it. I'm calling the sculpture done. I'm really happy with this one. It's going to be super cool. I cannot wait to get the mold on it and start casting these. It's going to be exciting. So could I have gotten it smoother? Probably, but I have to keep in mind a couple of things. I'm going to be casting these into clay, which is extremely easy to smooth, and we smooth out every slip casting we do. We lightly brush it over, so that's going to smooth it out even further. And also, this is all going to be coated with a beautiful glaze, like a nice satin glaze, which is going to cover that surface and smooth out that surface even more. You can see I've got my score line on the back, which is where we'll be cutting out. That's where the opening is going to be in the back of the mug for you to put the straw in. Yeah, I'm excited. Now I have to, what's next? I've got to put mold lines on this thing. I'm going to scribe my mold lines on there. I'm going to be taking it apart so I can take this, I'm going to take this top off. That's going to be molded separately. Lots to do. But yeah, I'm stoked. I think this mug is going to be molded in two pieces, and we're going to start with the simplest piece first, the top cap. This is going to be my favorite kind of mold, and that is a one-piece mold, and I'm going to build the box out of foam core, which I love using because you can make weird shapes like circles quickly and easily. Now, I'm super gluing on this little green circle of acrylic that I also cut on the laser cutter, and this, well, it's going to be tricky to explain, so
You'll see this shape will pay off later when we're doing the slip casting process. As a one-piece mold, that means I'm just making a box that I'm going to be filling with plaster. So here's my box, and I'm sticking all these little things on the side to keep the walls from deforming when I pour the heavy plaster into this box. I'm not agonizing over making this absolutely perfect because I know that I can sand and clean up the plaster when the mold is cast. I just really want to make sure the one part, this gray part, is good. The rest I'll sand. Okay, I have filled up the box with plaster and it is set, it's firm, and it's time to open up the mold and see what it looks like. Like I said, I'm not too worried about making this thing perfect because, as you can see here, I am going through and scraping and sanding and smoothing out all the plaster walls as I go through the demolding process. Alrighty, it is Friday. It was a bit of a short week as we went off on a little camping trip at the start of the week, so I didn't get that much time to do mold work, but as you can see, we've got the top cap molded and finished. It's looking great. So next step on this is to make a silicone mold of the master mold from which I can cast production molds. So this guy's ready to go. Next up on this guy, I am currently taking measurements for the mold box and how large we're gonna make this one. You can see I've sprayed it with some crystal clear acrylic spray to seal the clay. I'm gonna go through and release it next. I've got my parting lines drawn on there and it's got a weird hat. And that you will see is part of the well, the little top section of the mold that I use when I'm slip casting, and it's gonna let me really get a good clean edge when I trim the top part of this casting off. It doesn't make much sense now, but it will when we get later on. Hopefully it all works as planned. So I don't think I'm gonna be able to get much farther in the mold making for this Technical Tiki Tuesday. When we pick it up next, hopefully this guy will be ready to start pouring. Maybe, at least we'll be pouring plaster.